So this is Venkatesh Satya, an author and trainer and speaker also. And we are lucky to have him today in our show. And we'll be learning about him, about his journey, as well as his vision, and what all he trains people about. So welcome, Venkatesh, to our show. And we can start with a little of your intro and then actually your journey, step by step. Yes.
Yes, great. Thanks for inviting me. It's my privilege to address your invitation. I'm very happy to meet you today. And
Thank
the other
you.
Viewers who are watching this video, I wish them all the success. And to talk about me, yes. I basically born and brought up everything in Chennai, nothing outside Chennai. Like my childhood, schooling, college, work, everything in Chennai. But
yes.
However, I had to go out of Chennai as well for work-related purposes. That is inevitable. Uh-huh. And right from my childhood, my lifestyle is quite simple. And I had enjoyed all the advantages what my parents and family has given. And though I am not a good academic student, and I had to appreciate their patience and their trust on me, that though the academic was not so great, still they had some confidence in their mind somewhere.
Yeah.
So that helped me to grow up. And of course, I never had that interest towards academic. So I learned outside the syllabus, more than the syllabus in college time.
Okay.
And that helped me to get into my passion, what we call it as passion, and my vision started working from that, my college day itself.
Okay.
So I'm from a very joint family right from our childhood.
Yeah.
So I had that privilege of enjoying togetherness.
Yes.
That made me to realize what life is all about,
yeah,
being together and united. And
yeah,
currently I am working as an HR professional as well. That's my full-time job, where I am, to be specific, I'm an HR business partner.
Okay.
And I have more than a decade of experience in human resources work employment.
Yeah.
Apart from that, I have written 4 books.
Yeah.
All are self-improvement books. And
okay.
I have also been consulting certain companies and educational institutes on leadership and teamwork.
Okay.
So my forte is all about leadership, because it's my personal belief that everything comes in leadership. That's it.
Yeah. So somewhere I was reading, I was listening to one of your interviews, somebody else also had done. So you were saying that you were stammering during your childhood days. That is what you were saying. Yeah.
Yes.
Tell us
it
that
is there
story.
Even now. Actually, it's a daily goal for me to
yeah.
not to stammer.
Okay.
Because I can't help one factor, that it is something, it's generation, family, hereditary, what I'm having.
Yeah.
I'm not
yeah.
the only person I go through this.
Hmm.
My father, my other fathers, brothers.
Mm-hmm.
So my relatives also have that issue of effective speaking.
Okay.
So if you see, we will be speaking like a train. sometimes people find it hard to understand this in one go.
Yeah.
So I have to explain them again and again.
Oh, okay.
So it actually didn't didn't allow me to be an expressive or outspoken.
Okay.
It kept me in a very reserved manner, and also the inferiority complex developed in my school days. It was like a hell. And
yes.
because people
because of stammering.
Yes.
Oh.
Yeah. Huh. Because okay. I cannot
but
pronounce.
But you didn't stammer at all during this last.
That's what, it's a years of efforts.
Oh. Okay.
That's why.
Yeah.
That's why I say it's a daily goal for me.
yeah.
I cannot forget that, and I cannot simply go as usual. It is not normal for me. I have to be very conscious of what words I'm using.
Don't you think all of us actually stammer at one point or other because of this not being confident about something and we have to speak?
Yes, true.
Yeah.
True. For example, people when they see crowd in front of them, obviously they get lost of words. That's a true fact. Their focus goes on the problem than on the present situation.
Okay. Yeah.
So they get lost of the words. Uh-huh. Obviously, coming back to the own self is a solution.
Yeah. So that is very important that you are saying, coming back to the self. Yeah. So that is a huge, profound kind of revelation that you have made. And how does that actually you have taken into your training, HR training and something? You have taken that to your training also?
Yes. The thing is, more than others, my most complication happens with me. I have to manage myself than anybody else. I cannot control anybody. I can only control myself.
Yes, sir.
But in the past, it was not that mindset. I was thinking I have to manage others. I have to control others. No. It is the only person I have complete control is over me.
Yes.
Which was lost in the early stages. And then after self-realization, I had to come back to myself again and introspect within. And that's what spirituality is all about, right?
Coming
to yourself. It is going inward, not outward.
Yeah.
So I get into myself and I used my own tactics and strategies, helped others as well in their personal situations in training programs.
Yeah. So at what point of time actually you had this discovery about yourself that you have to go inward right now to overcome your shortcomings, whatever it may be?
Yes. One day I went to Coimbatore. It's one of the major cities in Tamil Nadu.
Yes.
Where I met one retired army colonel, because at that time I had the dream of joining Indian Armed Forces, so I had to prepare certain interviews. For that, I met him for some tips and suggestions.
Yeah.
Where just like you today, you said that I'm not stammering. He given me a big advice that helped me to go inward. The advice was like, don't ever say that you are stammering. I'm not seeing that you are stammering. Okay, he said. That is the day I understood that I'm able to manage it.
Yeah.
Though I'm not able to cure it, I'm able to manage it.
Yeah.
So when I stopped myself and thought that yes, if I could manage my major issue, what I thought it's a major issue, why can't I do anything else? Everything is possible. Whatever I do, everything is possible if I'm able to manage myself.
Yes.
So more than what others say, what I say about myself and what I think about myself is so important.
Yeah.
That made me to realize and discover my inward movement.
Okay. So how come you came into this HR sector? Like, see, you are a qualified HR person educationally?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. I seen human resources is closely related to training and people development.
Yes.
So since I love people and since I wanted to support people, I don't use the word help because it is quite sympathetic. So I use the word support. Since I personally want to support a number of people, I was unable to immediately get into the training sector without proper background and basement, because I was in a situation where I have to feed our family as well. So I had to go for a job, and I used human resources as a tool for my personal vision.
Okay. Okay.
So I'm currently using my personal job as a learning experience, and then I replicate into the training area.
Yeah, great. So no, what I was trying to say, how about your education? You were saying that you were not very qualified, not very academic.
Yes. Uh-huh. Great. I completed my graduation and I started doing MSc in psychology. But I, as I said, I'm not interested. I just dropped it actually. I didn't pursue it further. I'm something like never had that interest and never fan of our Indian education system. Yeah. And I have read non-syllabus books, more than 800 books I have read. Self-improvement books at the time. Mm. I never visited my college library. Mm. I was accused of that and I was denied the hall ticket in my college semester examination because I have never visited our library. Because I never use our academic books. I only use these self-improvement and non-syllabus books.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So then afterwards, after dropping this MSc psychology, you went to...
I was already working at the time. Okay. I started up as a part-time, but I continued my human resources profession. Mm-hmm. And slowly, since I was not so good at English in the earlier stage, comparing to now, okay? Mm-hmm. So it took me 4 to 5 years to complete my first book, actually. Okay. I started writing in 2010. I completed in 2014, December. Exactly.
Okay.
So I started writing with a single sentence a day. Mm-hmm. And then I got improvised it.
Okay. No, just continue with your academic journey, whether that has hampered into your professional. Like say how...
I have not done that. I have not done that, but I have done certification courses. Huh. Okay. I'm a certified life coach now. Okay. And I have also done behavioral skills training. So for benefiting my training purposes, I have approached and learned certain courses, mm-hmm. not the academics. Even I'm a certified research methodologist where I can research literature. Even quantitative, qualitative, all type of research I can do that helped me in my job as well as my training and speaking career as well.
Okay, so all those are done privately, other courses rather than being university degree or something.
Great.
So that is another thing, another pathway for people who are not very good at academics, and nowadays,
marks doesn't matter. I told this in my 10th standard. Till now, I stick to that statement.
Yes. So that was my view also, but for larger part of my career, actually, I was not accepted as well. So I now find a member also, a friend also, who is also substantiating the same view. Mm-hmm. So it also helps, building this kind of community where academics is not very important, but whatever your love is, you can actually pursue that and get very far in life and help many, many number of people. Yeah. So let us come back to our your authorship, how you have started and why did you think that writing a book will help you?
That's a great question. actually, as I said earlier, my full interest and enthusiasm towards training and speaking, though I'm not good at speaking, but my complete interest and enthusiasm towards speaking, addressing crowd, public speaking, that's how I had in my mind. But many of the times, for big inspiration, it starts somewhere little. We may not value it, but any big inspiration or any big idea starts from a small area.
Yeah.
So for me, I was browsing through an YouTube video channels in 2009 somewhere. So I watched an YouTube channel where that trainer advised the video watchers, viewers, to write a book that will help you to get the speaking gigs. Okay.
Yeah.
Actually, that's what happened today as well. Okay. So he was citing out certain examples that how he got opportunities, like in radio station podcasts, just because he was an author, he was invited to speak, not because he is a trainer.
Okay.
So that video was triggering my mind for a long time.
Oh.
So I started writing my first book with lots of research and studies and my experiences. And as I said earlier, I completed after 4.5 years later, and then it was self-published, the book.
Yeah. Okay.
So it's all about that video advice. Okay. I took it seriously and I started writing it just for the sole purpose that my writing will help my speaking and training vision.
Mm-hmm. So I was going through your latest book, Rise to Lead. So actually I couldn't, because I got it only yesterday, so I just had to just flipping through the pages, and the headlines were very interesting. So actually I could have gone through like say in say 2 or 3 days I can complete that book. So that also is another interesting aspect of your writing skill. So before coming to this book, actually tell us more about your first, second, third book as well, a bit.
Yes. My first book title is Leading Self and Others.
Okay. Right? Layering.
Leading. Leadership. Leading Self and Others.
Okay.
So we all talked about leading others, managing others, controlling others, influencing others, right?
Yeah.
But when I thought where the leadership actually starts is not with others, with ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? If you can't lead yourself, you cannot lead others. That's my mantra.
Very true. Yes.
Okay. You can ask anybody to do something, even if you have control over them, or if you have powers or position, you may ask them to do. But the most complicated person is yourself.
Yes.
How many plans you may, and how many plans you have taken into action?
Yeah.
Right? That's a very, very complicated thing.
Yes.
So the leadership starts within myself. So the first part of the book is self-leadership.
Mm-hmm.
And the second part of the book is about leading others. So as I said, leading others is all about others. It's out completely an outward notion.
Mm-hmm.
Where I believe certain 17 leadership must-haves. Mm-hmm. I have not specified it as a skill or qualities, but it's a must-have. So you must possess it.
Mm.
So that must-haves has been detailed in that book, Leading Self and Others.
Yeah,
it's my dream project. It still turned out to be my most favorite because it's first love.
So what about the second?
Second book is about greatness by choice.
Okay.
Everything happens by choice.
Yeah.
We all have choice at all the times.
Mm.
But the speciality of that book is it comes with the concept of CAP. C-A-P. CAP.
Okay.
So C for communication, A for action, P for perception.
Oh, very
so
good.
So these three things only governs our whole life actually.
Yeah, yeah.
The communication you have with others as well as with yourself.
Yeah.
Okay. The action. Without action, nothing moves.
Yes.
No matter how big plans you have or ideas you have, you will be appreciated only if your actions are good.
Yes. Yes. Right? Yes.
Thirdly, perception. Yeah. Whatever you see, that's what your reality. So based on your sense and your views, only your thought process happens.
Mm-hmm.
Thoughts just doesn't come. Based on your perception, it happens.
Yeah.
So, caption, that's what I said. Communication, action and perception. I covered this thing in that book. And thirdly, I wrote Just Reminding You. That's my third book. More than self-development, what we need is self-remembrance. Who we are, right?
Yes.
Sometimes we all know already. We know, mostly we know everything. But what we need is a reminder, right?
Yeah.
A simple reminder. We know that we need to wake up at 5 a.m. tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
But what we need is a reminder, an alarm.
Yeah.
So if we don't have that, we may miss out.
Mm-hmm.
So that book serves as a reminder for you what you already know.
Okay.
So that's my concept.
Yeah.
And fourth book is this Rise to Lead You. So okay. Again, I have gone into my root, leading mm-hmm. self and others concept.
Mm-hmm.
So for going little deeper, Rise to Lead You is a first part of leading self and others. It's mm-hmm. all about self-leadership.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But literally, spiritually centered approach.
Mm-hmm.
So this book has a sequel as well, next part mm-hmm. about leading others also coming up.
Okay. Okay. So how do you decide the timing of your book? Like say any incidents that leads you, or how do you decide which book and how many books? Like say, have you decided how many number of books you will write? Or
no, I really don't have plans to have a target in my mind how much to write.
Uh-huh.
I really write based on the needs, what I think.
Mm-hmm.
If there is really a need, I will write about it.
Yeah.
If I don't think anything as a need, I will not write about it.
Yeah.
That's what, based on the needs only I serve. That's what I feel. Simply because of having 20, 30 titles behind me doesn't help me. I personally feel that each and every book should be unique and it must add value to the reader.
Mm.
That's my view. So, unless I'm having that inspiration about the need, I will not write further.
Yeah. No, because you are already into the job, no? You are already training people and actually observing people going from one step to the other step. And actually inside you can sense their journey. So that will be again very interesting for you to inspire you to write further.
Yes, I have told many times even in my training, some of my best ideas come from my listeners.
Come
from my followers, because I constantly listen their stories.
Mm-hmm.
Fortunately, I'm quite patient with people.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
I listen to their stories as they are the whole world to me. I listen them. I offer my suggestions. I never advise people.
Uh-huh.
I offer my suggestions and I discuss with them. Sometimes they themselves have some wisdom that they may not aware of it. So I bring that out. I also use it for my purpose.
Yeah. So Venkatesh, this is the age of the say internet. And as I was telling you, we are a group of people who are doing this, helping coaches mm-hmm. and trainers expand their horizon, expand their business avenues mm-hmm. and reach out to more people, serve more people. So in that, this is an introduction to tell you that have you any plan to get use the internet for reaching out more people?
Yes, I am already working on it. I am already having a digital marketer with me who is a freelancer.
Okay.
So we are setting up our systems. Uh-huh. And definitely we will expand further.
Yeah.
So definitely I will approach other agencies as well to take over for increasing the brand.
What will be your the number one need that you would like your marketer to explore? For example, we actually help people. Like say, as you are saying that your audience is your main source of wisdom and inspiration. The same way, we also try to look for the need of our clients and know from them as to what service they need mm-hmm. and what, like say, everything is available right now everywhere, But what is the unique need which they think that still it is not available, and what kind of innovation they would need in the approach of other, like say, day-to-day digital marketing people do. Okay. Apart from this, what is the uniqueness that you would be liking for your expansion?
With regard to marketing, I have learned that you cannot completely learn the marketing systems and approaches and jump into marketing. Yeah. It is a trial and error approach for a long time.
Yeah.
Okay, you cannot decide that one fixed route that we identify and go about it. So as I said, I believe in trial and error things.
No, your route is very fine because you are looking for serving people, right? Mm-hmm. So when you are looking for serving people, it is itself is unique, and more people will get attracted to it. So that is the one route. The technical aspect of it you have to outsource. That is of course there, but already the intention is out there. But what in your vision, where do you want to reach? Like say, what is the ultimate?
My personal vision, you are asking.
Yeah.
Yes. Whenever that question comes into my mind itself, I think of one person who is my inspiration, John C. Maxwell.
Okay.
He is a world's renowned leadership expert.
Mm-hmm.
He is one of my biggest inspiration.
Mm-hmm.
So I need to become one of the world's greatest leadership mentor. That's my personal vision.
Yes.
So become a leadership mentor. It is not about having a great brand presence.
Mm-hmm.
It's about making positivity in our environment and touching people's lives in a positive way and inspiring them.
Yes. Yeah.
So that's my route. And my ultimatum is to become a greatest leadership mentor in the world.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you so much, Venkatesh, for your time and this thing. We will keep in touch about the other things. We may collaborate in future. And surely we will have a very, very strong friendship, whether other things click or not. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you
for your time.
Thank you.